Hi everyone, I hope you're well. Nick here, founder and director at Track Capital. So today I'm doing a video presentation regarding the Riviera beachfront in NBR City, Dubai. So the purpose of this is to give you a bit of an overview about the developer, the project itself, a bit about us as well, and just to provide you as much detail as possible on the opportunity, which we think is a fantastic one. So let's crack on with the presentation and I'll guide you through it. So firstly, just a bit about me. I'm the founder and director of a company called Track Capital, which is founded in the UK. So we built our business based on UK residential property, mostly in the northwest of England, places like Manchester and Liverpool. However, I've been coming to Dubai since 2014. I was working in the real estate market here back then. And recently we started to re-enter the market effectively. I absolutely love the quality of development here and the opportunity that Dubai provides. So I'm really happy to introduce these types of projects and developers to our investor network, which is just shy of 20,000 now all over the world. So yeah, I speak to developers and investors every day in Dubai and in the UK, although 80% of my time now is focused on the Dubai market. I've got extensive investment advisory experience. So we've taken multiple investors through the process from start to finish and achieved some great results and help people grow their portfolio safely and lucratively as well. I've got a variety of experience. So I've worked for multiple investment firms, UK's largest student accommodation developer, multiple property management companies back since 2012, which I started working for different firms. So I'm confident I've got a full understanding of the property market, both the operational side and the sales and investment side as well. So looking forward to passing that on to other people, really. We've got an office based in Business Bay, as well as our UK offices. So if anyone wants to come and meet face to face, more than welcome to come to our office in Business Bay. And then also we can meet developers directly at their offices as well. The purpose of me is effectively to be a point of contact from start to finish, you know, understand the differences between the UK and the Dubai market or the UAE market. I'll be your contact, your point of the ground right from start all the way till you start earning money in your account. I'll be here to assist. The other point as well is that I speak to developers daily. I go to the sites, I see the development. So yeah, I've got a strong understanding of the opportunities which are out there and how the ones that we handpick compare to those as well. So just very quickly about our company, we're direct to developer pricing, so we're always going to have the best market rate, exclusive incentives through us. There's no admin, sourcing or commission fees charged by Track Capital. We're members of the Property Ombudsman Scheme in the UK. We offer an end-to-end solution, so recommended mortgage brokers, lettings and management firms, etc. After sales service, that's a big one. We mostly sell off plan property, so you know, regular construction updates, site visits, whatever you need, that we'll be there to assist. And impartial advice. So we work with multiple developers, Imar, Zizi, Shoba, Select, DeMac. There's plenty that we work with, and we'll be happy to obviously assist and introduce you to the relevant parties. And finally, we offer referral fees. So anyone in your network who you think may be interested, then just let us know. Now, I'll start with a video of the Azizi Riviera project, because this will really set the scene and then we'll go into specifics after. I don't think you'll be able to hear audio here, but it's well worth it for the visuals, which gives you an idea of what to expect. So that teaser there is what we're going to be discussing today. So let's have a look at the actual project then. So this is a master community that's being built by a developer called Azizi, who are very, very well known in the UAE or Dubai market. Now, when we say master community, what we mean is they're building out a multitude of buildings and commercial outlets, etc. It's not just one building that's being built. There's actually 71 in total across the NBR city area and multiple developers involved. So we're focusing on Azizi Riviera. The idea being obviously the beachfront aspect is the core USP of the project. It's extremely unique. They're building a huge man-made lagoon, which is going to be ready by the end of next year. When we say lagoon, it's, you know, this is effectively a huge swimming pool. So you can swim in it, you can, you know, do water sports, etc. The whole community is being built around this, and it's, yeah, very, very unique indeed. So, yeah, I'll run through some key points. So it's in Maidan, MBR City, which is named after the Mohammed bin Rashid, the ruler of Dubai. It's priced from £160,000 or £800,000 dirhams, so AED. It's 10 minutes from downtown. And when we say 10 minutes, it's literally a 7-8 minute drive. It's very, very close to downtown Dubai. You've got studios, 1- and 2-bedroom apartments, which are available. Stunning views from into the lagoon, so effectively beachfront properties. And of course, the Dubai downtown skyline, which is unobstructed because over this side, which is, this is the apartments which are available here. This is Maidan 1, the new building, tallest residential building in the world, which is being developed. Yes, another one. And on this side, it's a villa community. So they're low, low, low rise. So you can look right across to downtown Dubai. Freehold apartments for UK buyers, that's a big one because they're used to buying leasehold. It's all freehold. Yes, apartment buildings. Yes, freehold. No ground rent to pay. Tax-free income during ownership and during resale. So capital gains tax, don't have to worry about income tax, etc., etc. It's very tax efficient to purchase in Dubai. For the UK buyers, obviously, you do need to weigh up what your tax is going to be on the UK side because it's going to be classified as additional income. So do bear that in mind. But from the UAE authority side, no tax will be deducted. A big opportunity here for high yields. You can operate a short-term let model. We'll discuss more on that later. But you can generate, you know, an 8-9% net income from having a management company advertise your property on Airbnb, Booking.com, Trivago, etc., etc. So big return on investments to be made. Multiple payment plans in place. So yeah, you can look at different options depending on the completion date. Mortgages. So for non-resident investors, you typically look at about a 60% loan to value level and fully managed. So goes back to what I was mentioning earlier. We can help you from start to finish with that complete process. So meeting the developer, choosing the product, choosing the unit, getting the construction updates, getting the properties let, whichever model you want to choose, securing finance as well if needed. So it's all teed up for remote investment. So now this is the internal effectively boulevard, i.e. road, in the beachfront Riviera development or master community. So as you can see, you'll effectively have buildings and commercial outlets. So these are, you know, restaurants, cafes. It's going to be a good buzzing atmosphere, a real community feel. And obviously tree-lined streets running straight down. So you're going to have the internal boulevard here, and then you're going to have obviously the beachfront. You know, every building has a swimming pool, a gym. Everything you need is going to be within this community. But this picture really shows you what you can expect. So development details themselves. So as we touched on, strong yields, but the completion dates vary. So some phase one is finishing very soon. That's about 85% complete. But some of the units we're looking at are for completion next year. So about 10 months time, Q3 next year. And then you can go to Q4 23 as well if you want to really pick out a special unit. So you've got a superb choice of apartments, a big wide variety, but the same core features because it's in the same master community. Excellent transport links, stunning views, obviously, generous terraces, i.e. balconies of each apartment. As I mentioned, you've got the restaurants, cafes, boutiques all there. You've got mega retail district, terraces, which we've mentioned, and a lot of the development is going to be devoted to natural beauty, i.e. parks, green space, etc., etc. So it's not a case where these developers are cramming in as much stock or, you know, apartments as possible. Dubai is all about, and the authorities, they want communities which are livable, they look beautiful, they attract tenants and owner occupiers. So it's crucial that they don't just let developers build out towers and towers and towers. You know, everywhere that's developed needs green spaces and it needs to be appealing for the residential community. So that's really important and one thing I like. So this gives you an idea of what you can expect. This is phase one, which is 85% complete. Obviously, this entire area is being redeveloped. We'll speak about what's happening in these areas shortly. But this area and to the right is all being redeveloped. And then there's other developers building over here as well. So you can see in the next 2-3 years, it's going to be a full community. This landscape is going to change drastically. And it's going to be full of villas, full of apartments, full of shopping, full of restaurants. And to benefit from growth in Dubai, this is the stage you have to buy. By the time this gets to completion, the prices will be at a premium. They would have gone up significantly, especially considering how busy the market is now. And we'll look at that data shortly. But buying off plan in Dubai is almost essential to get that capital growth. So here's a quick construction update. As you can see, this is a large scale. This is not like one guy knocking up a building. This is huge development we're seeing here. You can imagine when this street is finished, what you can expect going down the center of here. You know, tree lined streets, restaurants, cafes, a good buzz. But yeah, hopefully that gives you a quick overview. Here's an internal shot here as well. So there you go. There's a lagoon. You're going to have the views of downtown there, depending on which unit you buy, and obviously the terrace outside. But Azizi, really good quality developer. I've been to this site multiple times. I've stood in the construction site. I've been to their offices. I've seen their show flats. So I can personally say that the finish expected is going to be stunning. But I would encourage anyone who's in Dubai to meet up and go and meet the developer face to face. Have a look at the site. Once you're stood there and you get an idea of the scale of it and what they're looking to achieve, then it's you'll really buy into it. And obviously they've actually got show flats of what you can expect in Riviera in their sales office. So yeah, it's well worth the trip. So again, this is speaking about the master community, and I think this is a really good shot because it gives you an idea of what to expect on the finished product. So as you saw earlier, this is all effectively sand at the moment, and you've got the Riviera running along here, which is all Azizi. And then all this space at the back, we'll look at the site map in detail, but just quickly, all this site space at the back is greenery and parkland. So they're getting a really good balance between that green space, that, you know, community living, and the actual development as well. So really key point for me. Now, this bit here is developed by another developer called Shoba, who we also work with. Now, this goes back to what I was talking about. They can't just whack up loads of high-rise towers here because this is all villa space. So they're getting a good balance between villas and apartments. So yeah, that's a really important point for me because there's a danger if you buy in Dubai sometimes of them, because the development's so fast and aggressive, of them putting up a building next to you and obstructing your view. It's impossible. That can't happen here. So you're going to be looking over the lagoon here into the downtown skyline. This tower here is going to be the tallest residential building in the world, which they're also developing. So there's a lot happening in this immediate vicinity, which again makes it a destination, a living destination, not just a bland, copy and paste community. It's really unique. So you're gonna have the green social space, plenty of space for outdoor activities. You've got the lagoon, which obviously you can swim in, white sandy beaches. It's going to look absolutely incredible. You've got walkways, so evening walks and evening strolls. Again, tenants want, since COVID hit, tenants want and recognize and appreciate outdoor space. So gone are the times where a balcony is good enough for a tenant. You know, they need to have, especially in Dubai, where it's quite a competitive market, you need to have, pleasant parks to go in the evenings. Swimming pool, gym, this is all essential when you're buying in Dubai. Boutique shops, restaurants, and as we mentioned, the retail side of things. This is a bit about the location. So we'll look at the map, but you're very close to everything. 7-8 minutes from downtown, easy access to Sheikh Zayed Road. You've got the airport access, obviously, IKEA, which is really important, and the Medan Racecourse, which we haven't spoken about, but that's an example of another amenity which is very close by, close to the Palm Jumeirah. When we say close, look, this is, but it's, you know, 20 minutes away, so it's not, I wouldn't say it's on top of it, but for those that don't know Dubai, it's not a million miles away. Okay, this is a really important image here. So this is the site map. Okay, so here, we'll start from left to right. Here is the largest ski slope in the world. Okay, so just immediately left of this, they're building the Maidan Mall, which is going to be the largest mall in the world, bigger than Dubai Mall, which is currently the world's biggest. They're going to have the tower, which is going to be the world's tallest residential building, and you're going to have the world's tallest ski slope. So again, all these amenities in very close proximity to the apartments, yet you've still got the, you know, the beachfront lagoon feel, you've still got the walkways, you've still got the park, you've still got downtown 7-8 minutes away. So yeah, that's really, really important. You've got the balance of both. Now, all these numbered buildings are Azizi's developments. Okay, so you walk, I was in building 5 yesterday, so you drive along here. You know, this is actually all sand at the moment, but by the end of next year, the lagoon's going to be finished, and a lot of these phase one units are going to be finished as well. So at the moment, we have availability across some of these buildings, boulevard facing, so you can get here if you want more of the city chic feel, and you want to pay a bit less, more economical, or you can get the waterfront, so you can get facing downtown, literally beachfront properties. And I'd encourage you to look or think about, you know, what a beachfront apartment here is going to look like when you're advertising to tenants, you know, because you've got to think about, yes, it's nice to get good location, everything like that, but you've got to actually think about how the property is going to be marketed. You know, if you're advertising to a short-term let, imagine what your unit's going to look like on Airbnb. Yes, you're not going to do it physically. The management company will do it for you, but if you can get someone to stand on the balcony, take a photo and capture the promenade, the beachfront and downtown Dubai, it's going to be a real, real unique selling point for your visitors and your tenants. So yeah, this is the community. We've got beachfront units here. This is actually called beachfront. And then we've got the numbered buildings along here. You've got the boulevard going all the way around. You've got green space here. You've got all the amenities and the malls, etc. on the left side. Then here is the villa community I was speaking about. So although it's grass shown here, it's actually villas, but they're low, low, low rise. So they're not going to obstruct any views. Again, downtown, this is, everyone knows downtown, big master community developed by Emaar. There's very few space for development left. It'd be exceptionally hard to develop there at the moment. You've got Business Bay, which is where my office is, which runs around the outskirts of downtown Dubai, which is very commercial focused. There's a couple of new developments which are springing up, but yeah, to be in close proximity to downtown is crucial. Apartment and build specifications. So I won't read through these, but you can have a good look through. And yeah, we could potentially do virtual tours and things like that for you as well. Floor plans. Again, it's just a case of looking through and making sure you're happy with everything. Different sizes, different layouts available. So it all depends on what you're looking for. One bedroom apartment there, and up to the two beds as well. And look at the size of that balcony space as well. Again, here's another internal. You can see and get an understanding of the finish there. Okay, Dubai market information. So for those that don't know, Dubai is incredibly, incredibly busy at the moment. There's a huge amount of confidence in the Dubai market for a number of reasons. Just the Dubai brand continues to grow, how they've handled COVID, and how the government initiatives are playing out. So 100% business ownership for non-residents, various visa programs. You can get a visa if you invest above £150,000 or 750,000 dirhams for 3 years. And all these initiatives are all geared towards the population growth target, which is in place for Dubai. So we're currently sitting at 3.3 million residents. And for those that are in the UK, think of the size of, you know, Manchester, Birmingham, Liverpool. They're nowhere near the size and the scale of Dubai. It's just an absolute different league here. So yeah, the government's initiative is to drive, or target is to drive the population growth from 3.3 to 5.5 by 2040. So they're putting all these initiatives in place, visas, business structures, you know, they're building out the more stunning attractions. So think of the Dubai, which is effectively their London Eye, the malls which are being built, Jebel Ali, which hopefully one day will be finished as well. So there's a lot of stuff happening, and it's all aimed to drive population growth, which will in turn drive property demand. So values are obviously dictated by demand and supply. So lots of tenants coming here, lots of demand for buyers as well, all forcing values up. It's really, really crucial to consider that. And again, this is, it's not about listening to what a broker tells you. You've got to look at the evidence, you know, go online, have a look at the activity levels in Dubai. It's some of the busiest now since 2013. Off-plan market is huge, about 40-45% of transactions, thousands per month are in the off-plan market. So the model's proven in Dubai. We've seen it time and time again. So don't just base your investment decision on, oh, is it a good view? Look at the underperforming data as well and make sure you're buying in a solid community. Here's the view of the background. So the Medem Mall ski slope, and then obviously the Burj Khalifa as well. And I don't think I need to stress this, but you can buy an apartment looking out on the tallest building in the world. So it's, you know, at night it looks absolutely stunning. Excuse me. So right, for financial aspects, a couple of things to think about. There's various phases available. You've seen the number of buildings in Riviera, which are available for you to choose, and the payment plan, the time frames, etc. will all depend on which building you go for and the completion date. So what I say to people is just give me a budget to work with. So let me know how much you want to allocate to the investment. If you want advice on that, obviously we can let you know what type of deposit level or purchase price will get you, what type of development it will get you. But it's a lot easier if you have a set figure there and say, right, what can I get for this? And I'll give you specific options, specific payment plans, specific incentives where we can match it up to your criteria. Running costs, that's the usual for Dubai. So service charge, management fees, DIWA, utilities, if you're occupying the property yourself. Otherwise, the tenant will take care of that. DLD fees and government admin fees do apply. So just bear that in mind. We'll give you the exact information on that. And financing is available as well. So you can secure a 60% loan to value if you're a non-resident. Pricing, so studios start from £160,000, 800,000 dirhams. One bed apartments from 276,000 or 1,383,750 dirhams, and two beds from 416,000 up to just over 2 million dirhams. So what I would say is the developers do run various incentives now and then. So we can work to get you a good deal. It's, you know, it's just the nature of the market in Dubai. We'll work through together. We'll pick out a unit. We'll make sure it's available, and we'll get you the best price on the market. I can absolutely guarantee that. And there's a variety available, so bear that in mind. Get another internal shot of the bedroom. Security and risk profile. It's a big one, especially if you're investing remotely. People want to know their capital is safe and it's with a trusted partner. And what I would say is that the size and the quality of developers, not only is easy, just in general in the market in Dubai, is very, very appealing. So these are companies that have delivered thousands of units. Also, now the regulatory structure in Dubai is a lot more stringent. What I mean by that is escrow accounts have to be used, and developers have to demonstrate that they've got 50% capital outlay, or they've done 50% of the construction before they can start selling. Okay, so that's a regulatory requirement from the Real Estate Regulatory Authority in Dubai. So they actually don't have those types of restrictions in the UK. So in that side of things, it's a bit more regulated and a bit more safer. When you combine that with a developer with an extensive track record, when you combine it with a project that's well progressed anyway, and when you combine it with visits to either the developer's office or virtual viewings or where you see the finished product, then you'll get a really good, you know, you'll be filled with confidence in terms of what you're investing in. I mean, from a personal level, and then from our brand at Track Capital, we, you know, I could effectively go out there tomorrow and sell on behalf of any developer in Dubai, but we handpick, you know, there's probably four or five key ones that we work with. And we don't touch anyone else. That's it. I mean, we review, we keep an eye on the market, but it's all about working with those top tier developers. So hopefully that gives you some reassurance, but I'm happy to discuss that further with anyone that feels the need to. So why invest in off plan? It's a good point and something that we want to certainly think about. I'll run through these quickly and then I'll just give my personal take. So firstly, the pricing. So you will get a cheaper rate buying from the developer off plan. There's no question about it. There's a premium charged here for projects that are complete or closer to completion. If you buy off plan, you'll get a bigger capital growth rate during that construction period. If you buy off plan, again, it's not like the UK where sometimes new builds are a bit pricey. It's incredibly well priced if you look at the price per square foot. You're going to get a brand new property. It's going to be new. It's going to be shiny. There's going to be high tenant demand when you're buying the right place through Track Capital and with our trusted partners. So as a result, you're going to have minimal void periods. So you're going to be able to really maximize those rental returns on a monthly basis. Handpicked apartments, that's a big one. You've got to buy an apartment with either a good view or some kind of USP just to make sure you're distinguishing yourself. Car parking spaces are available. It's pretty standard in Dubai to get a space with the purchase price. Fully managed, hands-off, less investor input required in comparison to buying on the secondary market. If you buy somewhere that's 5-10 years old, it's going to be a bit more work to manage. A premium rental rate, because it's new, you'll charge a premium. Better resale potential if you're picking the attractive units early, i.e. if you're picking the units with the best view in these schemes, when you come to exit, when you come to sell, there's going to be high demand for your property. So that's really important to think about. And I just jotted that last bit on there. So this is more so along the lines of my personal thoughts. But for me, it's absolutely crucial to buy off plan in Dubai. Okay, it's crucial because by the time you get to completion, due to the level of activity that happens here, i.e. how many sales take place, you're left with the dribs and drabs. Okay, developers will be selling projects 18 months to 24 months from completion. So if something has been on the market for 2 years and not sold, there is a reason why. So you really do have to, in order to get a good, safe, solid, long-term investment, you have to buy off plan in Dubai. So here's more of a wow factor and gives you an idea of what to expect. So this is the beachfront aspect. So you've got the lagoon here. Again, this is going to be like an actual beach. So think what the Palm Jumeirah looks like. That's man-made. And yet you stand on the edge of that, you know, it looks absolutely stunning. So these are the apartments that are available, some lagoon-facing units and some internal boulevard-facing units. These buildings have all got pools on the other side as well. So you can get a pool view if you want, and you'll save quite a bit of capital from doing so. But as long as you've got some type of view, you'll be okay, right? So, you know, you don't really want to be on the ground floor or the first floor. You want to be a bit higher and you don't want to be facing, you know, another building directly. Unit selection and reservation. So once we've worked with your budget and picked out a unit, then we can consider things like, when we do pick out those units, we'll be considering things like the price, the size, the views, the layout, construction timeframes, what initiatives we can secure. All of this will be taken into account, right? So just give us your budget to work with. I will go away, pick out some units, give you a personal proposal, and we can narrow down the best one for you. Then if you want to proceed, we'll just lock that in with a developer. You pay your booking fee immediately, then your unit's secured. It's taken off the market. You don't have to worry. We'll then issue the sales and purchase agreement. This will come directly from the developer to yourself. And that's effectively a long form contract, which you'll read through, sign and return. In Dubai, it's a very streamlined process. It's very smooth. It's easy to do business here. There's not long-winded conveyancing like there is in the UK market. So yeah, it's all very safe. And what I would say is these developers, they have sales and purchase agreements as standard. So there's no messing with the agreement, there's no changes. It's just one rule for everyone. Very safe, very secure. Legal teams from all around the world have looked at these agreements, so you can rest assured they're very very safe and secure, robust. And then after that's done, obviously you'll make your relevant payments, you'll become the legal owner. On completion or just before completion, we can help you with mortgages or anything you want to know about the handover, the property management, the keys. You literally just call me or message me and I'll be there to assist. Just a couple of testimonials I've included here. So, you know, these are investors that have worked with us in the past and, have provided some positive feedback. So that's it, everyone. I hope that helps and wasn't too long-winded. You can get in touch with either myself or a member of the team at Track Capital to guide you through the investment process and your options. Riviera in general is a very, very attractive scheme. It's one I'm confident in. And the long-term play on that is going to be phenomenal. Yes, it looks early days now. Yes, it's a construction site, but that's how you're going to make money. You have to buy now while the prices are low. You have to have the vision to see long term. But providing you do that with a trusted broker, a trusted developer who's got a track record, who's progressed construction, who's well funded, you're buying in a good location, that's how you make money in the Dubai market. So hopefully that helps everyone. Any questions, give us a shout anytime. But I look forward to speaking to you soon.